At the end of Parshat Vayeishev, there was a puzzling Rashi dealing with the episode when Yosef interprets the dreams for the Sara Mashkim, the person appointed to be in charge of Paro's wine. After giving the Sara Mashkim the positive message, he says to him to please remember him, and he mentions actually twice to remember him to Paro so that he can get out of jail. Now, at the end of the Parsha, when the Torah talks about the Sara Mashkim actually being restored to his position, the Torah makes it a point to mention that the Sara Mashkim did not remember Yosef, and he forgot him. On this, Rashi points out, why did the Torah have to emphasize this? So he explains, because he wants us to understand that there's a reason why Yosef stays in prison for 2 more years, because the next Parsha, Parshat Miketz, mentions that after 2 years, Paro has some dreams. And because of those dreams, finally the Sara Mashkim tells Paro that when I was in prison 2 years ago, there was a Hebrew boy that came and interpreted my dreams properly, so perhaps he can come now and help you to interpret your dreams. Now, the difficult part of Rashi is in fact this. Rashi brings from Chazal that what was the problem? Why did Yosef have to stay in prison 2 extra years? Is because he put his trust in the Egyptian Sara Mashkim, in this Egyptian person that was, he felt, the way for him to get out of prison. What Rashi points out is that he should have put his trust in Hashem. The righteous put their trust in Hashem and not in the arrogant. And the difficulty with this is what I think everybody's going to ask. What was Yosef's crime? He's stuck in prison, he's innocent, and justice has failed him, of course, Egyptian justice. And now he knows that this person who he just did something good for is going to go in front of Paro himself, who can do anything, who can get him out of prison. So he says to him, please, remember me and tell him that I'm here so that you can help get me out. What is wrong with that? You know, after all, we all have to do ishtadlus. We all have to make an effort to help ourselves in situations that we're in. We're taught not to rely on miracles. As a matter of fact, people that do rely on miracles are criticized. And when a miracle is done for you, it can even detract from your merit. So what's wrong with Yosef's attempt to try to use natural means to get out of prison? So perhaps we can answer like this. In Yosef's case, since he asks the Sara Mashkim not to forget him twice, so from there we see that he was putting too much trust in him rather than in Hashem. Now, of course, an average person would not be penalized for saying to somebody, remember me twice. It's only normal. When I call somebody up and I need a favor and I'm asking him to do something for me, I might tell him 3-4 times, don't forget. But on Yosef's level, someone who walked literally with Hashem, as the pasuk earlier says that Hashem was with Yosef in everything he did, so for him, it should have been enough hishtadlus, enough effort to say it only once. The fact that he said it twice is really the source of the criticism of him and really the source of his mistake. Now, with this we can help appreciate what the commentaries actually mention. They discuss why was he sentenced to 2 extra years. And they mention that it's because he said it twice. So you see there's a connection. The only thing I would like to point out is perhaps the way I'm explaining it, we should say that only the second time was really the extra time that he shouldn't have said. But the first time was fine. So according to my explanation, he really should only have been punished for 1 extra year. But the answer to that is very simple, I think, that really by saying it a second time, it showed that even the first time, he was putting too much of his trust in the Egyptian Sara Mashkim. So that's why he's punished for 2 years. That is one way to appreciate this entire episode, but I would like to go now in a different direction and explain, because really this whole approach to me has a difficulty many readers will have. And the difficulty is this. After all, what is the message of the Torah here? What is the Torah trying to teach us? Not to do hishtadlus? To not to ask once or twice to someone that can help you to help you? The message as it applies to Yosef seemingly is overly critical. We're talking about a tzaddik on the highest level. So how do we learn? What is this message to us? Because it can be that we're not allowed to ask more than once. And of course, the simpler way to even learn it, there are those that learn that it was a mistake to even ask. That certainly doesn't apply to the average person. So I'd like to share with you an approach that really applies to the average person, and hopefully this could also be one of the ways to understand exactly what's happening in the Parsha. So let us look at it like this. Rashi's words on the episode are not that he shouldn't have asked or that he asked too many times. Rashi's words are, in fact, specifically that he put his trust in the Egyptian. This gives us the possibility of understanding Rashi's words in a different way. Really, the mistake of Yosef was an internal mistake. He put too much trust in the person. But to ask for help and to ask to be remembered is certainly within the realm of hishtadlus. And I would like to even say that even in Yosef's case, asking once and even twice was not the crime that Rashi is hinting to over here. Rashi is hinting to an internal matter, a matter of the heart between only him and Hashem. That's why he's punished in a unique way. There's no avera that he does. And when we have a lack of trust, we're not punished with an avera. And so why should he be punished for 2 years? But it's between him and Hashem. On this level that Yosef represented for putting too much trust, he was punished to be in there for 2 years. The fact that it matches the amount of times he said to remember me is just an external idea, but internally, the real shortcoming, or the real mistake, so to speak, from Yosef's perspective, was a lack of trust. And it manifests itself in asking twice, so he was punished for 2 years. But had he had the proper trust in Hashem, 100%, realizing that the Egyptian was only an emissary to bring about the divine will, so then perhaps we can say he wouldn't have been punished at all. And everything he did, even asking twice, would have been perfectly in line with what we call basic hishtadlut, which is making an effort, even for a tzaddik. Now, with this approach, we can all appreciate and understand a message that pertains to everybody. Life is hard. We go through challenges, scary moments. Sometimes the uphill battle seems so difficult that we're gonna fall. We have no strength to make it, and who do we turn to? Of course, we must turn to Hashem, because Hashem is the source of our salvation. As we say in the blessing of Shemona Esrei, He is our helper, He is our redeemer, and He is our savior. We have nothing without Hashem. David HaMelech says in the Pasuk, may God be amongst my helpers. Very difficult Pasuk to understand. If you have God, what do you need helpers? The answer is that God comes and works through our helpers, but it's really God helping. When God is with our helpers, then they'll help. If God's not with those helpers, then nothing will help. And so we have to remember, when we do our effort, when we do our status, when we call a lawyer, when we call a doctor, when we ask a friend for help, advice, someone who has money that we think he's gonna help us, he's gonna give us the job we need, it's true, we need all those situations and we are dependent on those people to a certain level. But again, only if God is with them and with us, with the effort, will we see true blessing and true success.